During the reign of Ming Emperor Jiajing, in the early 16th century, the east coast of China was plagued by pirate raids. They were called Japanese pirates because many of them were rogue Japanese samurai, or ronin. They raided one town after another without settling anywhere long term. Their favorite weapon was a Japanese sword. There were a number of types of Japanese swords, but the earliest types were basically variations of those of the Tang Dynasty. Tang swords were masterpieces of art and technology that inspired Japanese sword makers to create their own unique versions. Japanese swords became known for their sharp blades. In the Ming Dynasty, the Japanese sword became the go-to weapon for the pirates and a symbol of their bloodthirstiness. Yu Ting, a kendo coach who's fascinated by samurai swords, will wield the swords in our test. In ancient Japan, a sword was tested with a pile of corpses. If a sword was able to cut one body in half with a single strike, it was rated as a one-body sword. And if it could cut two bodies in half, it would be rated as a two-body sword. The sharpest sword was allegedly a seven-body sword. But the one we will use in the test is not that sharp.
创臂也比较平整，哦，有没有砍透了？这作为人来说，也就是成了开放性胸腔胸部的损伤。要伤到肺脏，这个马上就会造成血气胸了，就危及生命。这个斩击的效果啊，可能不像是大家想象的那样，说是这个武士刀呢可以无坚不摧的感觉。很多层的这种肌肉组织、脂肪组织、骨骼组织摞在一起，那么它有很大的一个弹性。
如果说没有它下面的这些这种覆盖的话，那么应该适合我们平时施展的一个效果。对于一个普通人是完全可以的。According
to the novel Tales of the Pirate Upheaval by Sai Ju Da from 1558, a Japanese pirate could cut over a dozen lances in half with one blow. It seems unlikely the lances were so fragile, so we're going to carry out a test with a stationary lance pull to see if this is possible. Though there are no actual historical references concerning its power, the test showed that the sword could cut a lance in two. Their sharp blades and combat skills gave the pirates the advantage in one-to-one combat with Chinese soldiers. The influence of samurai culture can be seen today in the modern Japanese martial art of kendo.
Kendo 本身的特点呢是就是要积极的创造时机，然后呢，如果时机出现的话呢，就要一击必杀，但是不会轻易的乱出手。
The samurais who joined the pirates had previously received strict training. As part of their training, they were required to watch an execution to strengthen their resolve. Wudang, a Chinese martial artist, is wielding a standard Ming army lance. For thousands of years, the lance was one of the most important military weapons in China. We're now going to see how a Chinese lance does against a Japanese sword.
在剑道理论里边呢，也有对这种长柄武器的这种战斗的方法。那么长枪的话呢，它也是一种长柄武器。那么对长柄武器的话呢，可以说最重要的内容就是这个双方距离上的差别。既然让他先出手，因为他出手的时候他会向前，他会向前的话，那么我再向前，再突破这段距离就会变得比较容易。
也明快、精干、实用，具有很强的杀伤力。这个枪的优势就是一寸长，一寸强，但是呢，握刀呢还有一寸短，一寸险。这个呢，最终取决于持枪者或者持刀者两个人的能力。
Yu Jing and Cheng Yu Gang are skilled martial artists, but most Ming soldiers were originally peasants whose skills were no match for the fighting skills of the pirates. 明 General Qi Ji Guang once wrote that his soldiers could not be effective with their short swords.And were inept with their long-handled weapons, so they were helpless against an enemy.
Because 明朝的主要的当时的这个边防的任务是对北方作战，所以呢，从山东去的，比如说长枪手，他练习的是在平原上对骑兵作战。那么他到了南方的山地呢，他训练再好，你单一的长枪手到了树林，到了这个地形崎岖的地方，你就不便发挥作用。
The pirates not only had superior weapons and combat skills.They were also more familiar with the terrain along the coast than the Ming soldiers from the north. Qi Ji Guang therefore decided to recruit new soldiers locally. There were many miners and coolies in Yi Wu, Jiajing, and they often engaged in violence. Qi Ji Guang recruited some of them and developed them into a brave and disciplined force.Capable of standing up to the pirates. Qi Ji Guang's soldiers were armed with a unique weapon made of bamboo called the wolf brush, which the pirates had never seen before. It seems hard to believe that a weapon of bamboo could be a match for a weapon of steel. Bamboo grows all over Southeast Asia, where it's a common food and construction material. The local soldiers fasten spikes on bamboo branches to resemble a large brush. They call this unique weapon a wolf brush. This type of bamboo brush was originally an implement used in tea ceremonies to gently stir powdered green tea leaves. The weapon was easy to make out of readily available materials, so the army was quickly supplied with them.
实际上，郎线呢，在明朝早期的军队里也有使用，但是呢，和倭寇作战的时候效果不好，尤其是这种枝枝杈杈的东西，如果逃兵把它丢在战场上，会妨碍本方军队的进退。所以从这个意义上说呢，只有到了这个明朝中期戚继光的戚家军，他用合理的战术和编制，把这个郎线的作用发挥出来。
Qi Guang developed six ways to use the wolf brush, based on lance and spear techniques. Some were for attacking and advancing, and some for defending and retreating. The simplicity of the techniques enabled the newly recruited warriors to quickly become skilled with the wolf brush. Meanwhile, the tide began to turn against the pirates. We're going to carry out a test to gauge the power of the wolf brush. Cheng Yugeng struck the pig carcass with the wolf brush, but the spikes apparently caused no damage. Its real power comes from the spear point in the middle of the brush.
在这个侧枝刺的这些部位，咱们看不到明显的损伤，是吧？只是在这个部位有一个不足2毫米的一个划伤。 非常表浅，主枪头造成的损伤，创口都挺大，创眼整齐，创壁平滑，是吧？大部分都已经是贯通了，在当时的医疗条件下，技术水平，估计生命都难以保证。
The spikes on the branches didn't seem to have much effect, but they must have served some purpose.
It 实际上它主要的任务是防守。那么对于这个倭寇的长技呢，有两项，一个是呢它这个就是采取的用倭刀，并且它是这一刀一步的距离，它就跳过来打，所以呢狼线必须足够长才能顶住它。
It was a landslide victory, just as the pirates imagined. But it was the Ming forces that were victorious. Yeah! When a pirate was busy defending himself from a bamboo brush, other Ming soldiers took the opportunity to attack him with lances and firearms. Qi Jiguang was a creative genius in military affairs. He created the famous duck formation, which organized units with different weapons to work together to defeat the pirates.
Yeah! 实际上，他只不过是把以前的兵器重新组合了一下。那么以前可能是，比如说100个长枪手变成一队，那么这个100个短刀手和藤牌手变成一队，这种大编制很适合北方作战，但是到南方就不行。 所以戚家军呢，他从最基层的小队开始，他就是这个混编的。The
formation was so called because it resembled a flock of ducks in flight. 。Soldiers wielding wolf brushes were in the front as the first defensive line, which helped stabilize the whole formation. 。There was a confrontation between the soft and inexpensive wolf brushes and the sharp and expensive samurai swords.
Hey, 从你一出阵呢，就要把这个狼线的尖指向对方的胸口，对，这样呢让他不能近身，是，这是狼线最基本的姿势。然后呢。 哇，居然砍断了！从这个地方看呢，刀还是很快的，因为它切的这个断面非常平。然后你再把狼线向前伸，对，已经斩断的狼线，你拿到尾端的时候，你看，它切掉的正好是差不多这么长一段。现在基本上又暂时还能再抵抗一阵，再来一个回合没问题。
如果说他要等到切到这儿的时候，就实际上他需要做好几组批次的动作，这个时间足够两翼的这个队友来解决问题的。本身这个武士刀啊，它呢并不主张的这么多的去斩击对手的兵刃，但是像这个狼线这武器呢，就迫使这个可能是武士呢就选择一种不适合他自己的一种战斗方法。
对，然后等到后期再出现铁狼线，更不好对付。
对，那肯定不能砍了。
The wolf brush was much more effective than lances and spears in preventing the pirates from making their usual rapid jabbing attack. Qi Jiguang's amateur soldiers were now able to defeat the well-trained pirates. The duck formation could easily be adjusted for different geographical conditions. It could be spread out like a duck opening its wings where conditions permit. For instance, with both wings having both defensive and offensive capabilities.
可能有一边是防，一边是攻，就是齐正，不知道哪边是，这由指挥官来定。
The two wings can also squeeze toward the center of the formation when the battlefield is a narrow stretch of land.
那么它既可以用来进行纵深进攻呢，也可以就是说在前面牺牲的时候又建立一道防线进行防御。
Another variation is a triad formation, in which the middle soldiers are responsible for defense, with the two flanks responsible for attack.
是所有负责防御的兵器全在中间，负责防御，而这两边呢，就像这个螃蟹的两个钳子一样，是负责杀敌的。
The wolf brush and the duck formation proved very effective against the Japanese pirates, totally eliminating the threat of the coastal raids. 的 pirates began avoiding confrontations with Qi Ji Guang's army. Thanks to the bravery of Qi and his army in fighting the pirates, the coastal areas of Zhejiang and Fujian once again experienced peace. 戚继光's army was one of the greatest in Chinese history. It was never defeated in hundreds of battles. 戚继光 became a notable historical figure for his military accomplishments, as well as for his heroic contributions in defending his nation and fellow countrymen.